Soon here at ringside with my colleague Jesse the Body Ventura.
That's right, Gorilla. I'm pumped up. I'm here to call it like it is, as Jesse the Body always does.
A tremendous happening right here.
You won't find any better action anywhere.
Well, I'll tell you what, Gorilla, I'm pumped up. I'm happy to be a part of it. It's great to be back with you.
It's my pleasure to be here with you and part of this happening. Unbelievable.
Here we go. Time for talk is ended.
Absolutely.
They're ready. They've trained hard. What a matchup this is going to be, Gorilla Monsoon.
Unbelievable ovation as they're hanging off the rafters. Just take a look at the fantastic spillover crowd here for this extravaganza. The World Wrestling Federation outdoing itself and presenting this unbelievable card of wrestling.
I'm so excited, Jess. You can feel the electricity in the air here. You can grab a hold of it, touch it, cut it.
That's right. It's everything I expected it to be, Gino Monsoon.
Boy, you said that right, Jesse. And this is just an international affair. We're just deluged here by cameramen and newspaper reporters from all over the entire world wanting to cover this event.
Boy, it's a happening. This is going to be a classic matchup. You're going to see some tremendous moves in this bout.
Speed, agility, knowledge, it's all in there. All the ingredients necessary for a great match. This will separate the men from the boys right here.
Well, Gorilla, you can feel the tension right now. This is what it's all come down to.
You can cut it with a knife. You can feel the electricity in the air.
You're going to see some fine wrestling here.
Absolutely. Take a look at the charisma. Take a look at the power pack.
Oh, definitely. They're both in great shape. Great shape. I got to do my normal. Say hi to my four biggest fans in Minneapolis. Terry, Tyrell, Jake, Jeremiah.
They could be the only four.
What are you talking about?
I don't know. I never heard you say hello to anybody else before. Yeah, you're a long way from home, Jeff.
Halfway across the country. Prince is watching at my house.
Oh, Prince.
He's a big fan, you know.
I understood just that your dog was named Prince. Is that correct?
Someone disinformed me. You're all full of misinformation, Monsoon. We may see some rule breaking here. You like to believe all scientific, but you'll see greed come out.
I'll be surprised, Jess. I'll be surprised. Both men of extremely high character.
Tremendous respect for each other.
I can feel the volcano getting ready to erupt, Gorilla.
You think so?
Oh, I can feel it, the tension.
Give me a break, Jess.
How come you don't believe everything I tell you?
Because sometimes you're a fountain of misinformation.
Never. I'm the man who tells it like it is.
Must have had some steam on your lenses.
You're worse than Watergate.
At that point in time.
Yeah, how are you going to win if you ain't aggressive? You injure something, you go after it. What is this?
He's also a sportsman, Jess.
A sportsman. Sportsmen are only involved in duck hunting and pheasant hunting.
Not an easy hold to counter. He certainly can hurt you in a lot of ways.
Yeah, that's smart wrestling. You know, if you can get your body in the way of that referee, it's pretty
damaged. Dirty wrestling.
Dirty wrestling, smart wrestling, it's winning wrestling, Gorilla. Now don't you dare tell me you never thought of nobody.
I may resemble that remark.
Yeah, I remember you and Jack Dempsey back in 26. Always remember, it ain't how you play the game, it's whether you win or lose.
That's not exactly what I heard your motto was, Jess.
What you hear?
I remember you saying many times you had a shirt made that said, win if you can, lose if you must, but always cheat.
That's true, too.
No, I thought that was right.
That's true, too.
You resemble that.
But like I said, you know, all's fair in love and war.
wild bulls.
This is a straight grudge match right here. These two guys just do not like each other. No love lost here. This is going to be a classic confrontation here. You got two veteran wrestlers.
These two guys also just are the type of guys who, if necessary, could wrestle for an hour and a half.
Definitely. I'll tell you, these are like two big Mack trucks climbing head on.
Irresistible force meeting the immovable object. Both of these guys will be pulling out all the stops. You can bet on that one. Can you imagine just what's going through the minds of these two individuals?
Gorilla Hounds, how would you like to be that little referee having to try to contain these two guys?
Well, that's where you use the count, Jess. You don't try to physically step between these guys, but you can squash like a brick.
I like to take my time, too. It's a psych-out thing.
That's Gorilla Monsoon.
It's a psych-out. You get your opponent, you get him upset. Just those little added edges can mean the difference between victory or defeat.
Very, very important part of professional wrestling, psychology, and no one knows it any better than my colleague. Very well put, Jesse.
Well, it's important, the pace of a match. Some guys like a slower pace, other guys like a faster pace. And if you can get your opponent to wrestle at the pace you want to go at, that's to your advantage at all times. You know that as well as
well,
I do, Gino.
My key was never play another man's game, Jess.
That's right.
You know, make him play your game if at all possible. Don't play his, and if you can't get either one, then just wing it.
That's right.
Seesaw battle going on here, Jess.
Definitely a good matchup.
How quick the momentum can change in professional wrestling and the tide turn, so to speak. If you don't have a basic wrestling knowledge, you can forget about it.
That's right. Unless possibly you're an awesome individual like a King Kong Bundy.
Well, I understand that he also has a tremendous amateur background.
That makes him doubly bad. Doubly bad.
It's like having dynamite with a short fuse.
Apparently some damage done to that
tore a hamstring in there, Jeff.
Hamstring muscle or whatever, sure.
It happens all the time, plenty of injuries.
That's what I talked about. I thought it was a stupid move.
Well, I disagreed with you then, and I disagree with you now.
Yeah, well, look, apparently he's injured himself.
It happens all the time, Jesse. It goes with the territory. I understand somebody's in jeopardy of losing their yacht, Jesse. Is that correct?
Woo.
One of your billionaire friends? I don't know.
Not Marv.
Oh, no. I didn't say anything. Did I?
No.
I know you like to rub elbows with those guys, Jeff.
No. They like to rub elbows with me.
Sorry. Find out all the Hollywood gossip.
Sure. I was on the plane the other day with Farrah Fawcett.
You were?
Couldn't keep her away from me. Had to call the stewardesses for help.
Substantiate that.
Certainly. Ryan O'Neal saw the whole thing.
I doubt it.
Had a chance to see Mr. Perfect's father, Larry the Axe, hitting.
Yes, I did.
Still got a 24-inch neck. He said he had to lose 20 pounds. I said, get your neck down to 18, you'll lose it.
Oh, one of the big fans, Jess, of the WWF.
Yep, Sugar Ray Leonard. I guess you'd call him the undisputed middleweight champ now, right? I'd dispute it, though, because I think Marvin Hagler won.
Well, you have enough undisputed things to claim, Jess. Bob Uecker was here last year. What a guy.
Well, I won't talk so good about Bob Uecker. To me, he ain't such a great guy.
How about Vanna White then?
Well, I keep hush on Vanna, you know.
Oh, Bobby, welcome.
All right. Hey, this is it, man. This is the first time I ever had an option renewed. Second year for me, Gorilla.
Glad to have you back, Bobby.
Well, I guess it's okay. You know, like they said, they renewed your contract. Like you said, you never got that in baseball,
right.
Uecker. 1 year with each team there.
Hey, all right.
Come on.
I'm looking forward to it, man. Good to be back with you and you.
I'm going to have trouble, I can tell, here. City between the Uecker and the body.
I don't think Vanna White has to worry about getting chased around.
Oh, she's having a good time eluding Mr. Baseball. Oh, she's definitely here, you.
Yeah, I'm supposed to meet her. That's the main reason
for being here.
That's your main reason for being here?
Yeah.
Vanna White?
Yeah. I'm supposed to meet her here someplace.
Well, do you have any idea that she's in love with me?
I saw something about that in some tabloid. No, that's not her.
It was, in fact, the National Examiner, you.
Is that where it was?
Page, yes.
She wouldn't come here unless she got a date from me. Now it's very upset about that. Jack Tunney never asked me.
Yeah. I'm sure you're aware, Yuke, that the body is going to be behind the broadcast. The group is off the baseball.
Yes, I know that. I heard all about it.
Well, I'll tell you what, Yuke, you'll never see nothing like this in baseball, will you?
Ah, this looks like the final day of cutdown day in spring training to me. Boy, Dr. Frank Joe would have a picnic at this thing.
Hey, Euchre, you know something?
Yeah, what?
With your lifetime batting average of 200, that means with every swing, you could only hit one guy out of five.
The only thing, if I ever had a good year, it would mess me all up now, you know? Woo! That's why I never wanted to be an MVP, just for reasons like that. Good example.
That's why you hit 200, huh? That'll keep you out of that running. Well, you know, Yuke, if Anna has good taste, you know she's less billing now.
Yeah.
Please.
Yeah, I'm very familiar with that.
Well, you can stop.
You know, that's like kind of like talking to the third base coach before you lay down the bunt, Yuke.
You're familiar with that.
But then again, in your case, Yuke, you got to make contact with the ball.
Yeah, most of my third base conversations came from the dugout.
Well, you know, when money's involved, there ain't no friends, Yuke.
You would know about that, wouldn't you, big boy?
Definitely.
Well, guys, hey, look, it's really been nice. Really been nice being up here with you. I told you earlier.
Bailing out already?
Yeah, I'm bailing out, man. I'm here to see Fana. She's someplace in this arena looking for me, and we missed connections when I came in here to the announce booth. Fana, if you're listening here on closed circuit, I'm on my way, darling. Hang on wherever you are, and security, please be careful with her. Fana, I'm on my way.
You got after her vowels?
No. Just a letter here and there.
Oh, okay.
Well, see you guys.
Yuke bailing out of the broadcast position, heading and going out to try to find Vanna.
You know what the funny thing is, Corella? I know right where she's at, but I just can't say my room number over the air.
Oh, come on. Please. Well, she didn't deny that article that was in the Examiner, did she?
Well, neither did I.
No, I guess not. This one has gone a long time, Jess. I don't have a clue how much time has elapsed, but it's got to be well past 10 minutes already.
I bet you on these guys' bodies, it feels like 45 minutes right now. Tell me, Gorilla, what was your biggest weight you wrestled at?
440.
What the heck did you eat when you weighed 440?
Just about everything.
I know you were on a seafood diet, right?
Yeah.
You ate everything you saw. You know, this match could end up who's got the most endurance in 5 minutes. Neither one of them's going to have anything left.
I'm afraid I have to agree with you, Jess. Although when I was at my heaviest at 440, I could go an hour out there, Jess. This match has gone longer than I expected it to go, Jess.
Really?
Right. Absolutely. I expected they would come out here and in the first couple of minutes, let it all hang out and see what happens.
As old Yogi says, Gorilla, it ain't over till it's over.
That's right.
And there ain't no point system in the pros.
Absolutely not.
I can't even hear you, Gorilla, hardly.
That may be a blessing in disguise.
That could be.
For me.
Gorilla,
could you tell that from this vantage point?
You're darn right I could. I don't have Coke bottle glasses on.
Oh, you are.
I got 20/20 hearing, Hanson. Clean out your ears.
Sometimes it's a little bit difficult to understand you.
Well, that's a cheap shot, Gorilla.
I thought it was rather exciting and rather innovative. Get his attention right away. Make him burn up some more energy.
I don't think I'd want this guy's attention.
Mr. Moves.
I would have left him daydreaming.
You think so?
Hey.
He's been there before. He knows what it's all about. You're not going to psych him out either, Jess.
He's as dirty as they get, Gorilla.
I don't think that's the case at all. But nevertheless, Jess, you don't settle anything out there in the middle of a match. You know that, and I know that. It's an unwritten law in the world of professional wrestling. You've got problems, you settle them outside the ring, not inside.
Yeah, but Gorilla, remember something. Laws are made to be broken. That's another Jesse Robert.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I'm here to hear that.
You know, the wolf climbing the hill is always hungrier than the one that's on top.
Even after you double-cross somebody.
That gives you all the more reason.
Everything is history up till now. This is a happening. This is what's going on.
You know, playing devil's advocate, a little gorilla. You call it whatever way you see it. I always do. Yeah, I'm the only announcer that does.
He seemed to soften him up a little bit with that last one, though. He might have caught him on the bridge of the nose. You know what kind of pain that can generate.
Now, how could you tell?
I could tell from my bed.
With those Coke bottle glasses you wear, you could tell.
Yes.
You know, I always say that sometimes the little things are the devastating things. A good old thumb to the eye.
What a disgusting type of move.
Can you blame him?
No.
That's skill wrestling, Gorilla.
That's cheating, my bro.
It's skill. It ain't cheap, Gorilla, unless you get caught.
Unless you get caught, yeah, I understand. Those are your rules.
That's the American way, the American rules.
Well, it just makes me glad I retired.
Makes me glad you retired, too.
Well, a lot of guys were glad when I retired.
You can't win fair, cheap.
Yeah, that's your motto. Win if you can, lose if you must, but always cheap.
You know, Gorilla, that's how all the great fortunes were made. You
think so?
Certainly. Same thing goes at the blackjack table. Cheap.
This is unfair. This is not right.
Oh, this is unfair, but earlier, that was all fair, right, Gorilla? You're cool with that. Oh, yeah, that's right. You didn't see any of that. You were too busy stuffing another hot dog down.
I was busy trying to digest some of the verbiage that you've been laying on me.
Did you ever eat one of Chico's enchiladas?
No.
Oh. You're not normal for a week.
Well, I like that kind of food, Jess, but it doesn't like me.
You know, let me ask you something, Gorilla. You look like you ate a whole pumpkin pie today.
Will you stop?
I can't believe
you're just jealous because you didn't get it.
Whipped cream and all, I'll bet, huh?
I'm surprised at the lack of output.
Well, maybe they, I don't know.
Are they in awe?
Could be.
It happens. Happened to me in Madison Square Garden, I'll tell you that.
From what I heard, it happened on more than one occasion.
Oh, well, the word submit is not in their vocabulary.
Gorilla, you can beat anybody with a submission hold if you get it on right. I don't care who you are. Come on, you ought to know that.
I know the determination.
Hey, you can have all the determination you want.
Right. Ever heard the story of David and Goliath?
Yeah, he used a foreign object, too.
Well?
Come on, Gorilla, quit playing such favorites out here.
If the shoe fits, put it on. That's what I say.
I'm right? Starting. You know, I used to like broadcasting with you. You're getting worse than McMahon.
I am.
Well, you know, the guy's got $1 million body and a 10-cent brain.
Why don't you tell him that face to face?
I don't have to. I'm way up here with you, Gorilla.
You're safe here, right? You like to be in broadcast position as opposed to being down there in the ring.
What are you talking about? I've been out 2 years. I could go down there right now.
Well, I'd buy a ticket to see that. Let's be realistic. You're out there in Hollywood.
I'm all over the country, Gorilla. I have eyes and ears everywhere.
Oh, stooges, you mean?
Stooges? Don't ask me, Gorilla.
Well, you traveled all over the world.
That I have.
Your heyday? I'm sure you were.
What is this in my heyday stuff?
Well, I'm going way back now, just to when you remember the SEALs.
It was only about 5 years ago.
Oh, I mean. 5 years ago? Great. You had the gold around your waist, Jess. You know what it's like.
I like it because you know me, Gorilla. I've always been one to enjoy colorful things.
You certainly have. You just get in there with whoever it is.
I used to.
Well, yeah, you used to complain a lot. I remember that.
And I also got a lot of experience in tag team wrestling.
I know that.
The Honky Tonk Man, he held the title longer than anybody.
Claimed to be the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time.
Well, you know, if you count just strictly time duration.
Held it longer than Pat Patterson?
Pat Patterson?
There's a name out of the past.
No kid, what a relic he was.
Well, at least it gives something away to the fans. I remember you never threw any of those earrings of yours out.
Monsoon, my earrings are covered with diamonds and stones. What do you think?
Oh,
I'm going to throw out $5,000 pair of earrings to some idiot?
Highly unlikely.
Yeah, you got that right.
No, not that you would throw them out, that they cost $5,000.
Oh, be careful. This match could be over in a second here if you do that.
That's right. You lay a hand on a referee, it's bell time.
I seem to remember you doing that several times during your career, Jeff.
Never on a referee that didn't have it coming.
Look out. We'll be lucky if the ring stays together.
You better step into that ring and you better be prepared to go because you can bet your opponent is.
Absolutely. Pull out all the stops.
Gorilla?
Sure, Wild Red Berry.
Wild Red Berry.
Yeah, he's since passed away.
There's a name out of the past, definitely.
Brain! Where's the brain? You seen him, Jess?
The brain's always there when one of his men wrestled, Gorilla.
Well, the brain has to see.
Brain has too much invested.
Boy, I'll be anxious to get back in the locker room when this is over and have a few words back there and see what's going on now with the Heenan family. He's not too happy.
Bobby the Brain's got a lot on his mind, Gorilla.
Obviously, you wouldn't know, you never had a manager.
I had a manager in 81, Classy Freddy Blassie.
Yeah, and he took your career right down the toilet.
Hey, Heenan's a pretty tough guy. If you were to go against him, I'd bet on Heenan anyway.
I'll hold the money.
You'll hold the money, you'd be flat on your back. Call him the Brain.
The Weasel.
You mean Bobby Heenan?
Yeah, his nickname is the Weasel. I'm sure you're aware of that.
Yeah, by people like you, it's his nickname. You know, Monsoon, you ought to quit knocking Bobby Heenan. He's just proving why he's the head of the Heenan family.
Well, that's your opinion and your title to it.
Why is it everyone likes to beat up poor Jimmy?
Because he's a pain you don't wear, Jess.
No, it's because he's small and there's bullies. No. Everywhere you find him.
He sticks his nose where it don't belong a lot of times. You know what
he did to the minds out there. What he did to the Hearts was totally legal.
Uh-huh.
He owned a portion of their contract. If he wanted to give it to the Rougeaus, why not? It's America.
Sure.
Especially now because the Rougeaus are American boys.
Well, no, that's not so bad.
Just hey, wait a minute, Gorilla. Wait a minute. Now, didn't your parents come from some foreign country?
Yes.
Well, then they're no different than
country.
You.
The Rougeaus were not born here.
So, in other words, Gorilla, as far as you're concerned, tear down the Statue of Liberty?
No, I didn't say that.
And if anybody can bring him around, it's the man outside the mouth.
Uh-huh. Or desert him, or sell him down the river.
The mouth with the megaphone.
Certainly has a reputation.
He told me that the reason he brings the megaphone down now is because he says your play-by-play comments are not up to par with his men wrestle, so he likes to handle them.
Yeah, he would. I don't trust this guy as far as I can throw him across the street.
He is a henchman, a stooge. You know what I love, though, Gorilla? You can come up with all those derogatory adjectives sitting up here because you're 200 yards away from him. Brilliant.
He's a sneak and a snake.
Sneak and a snake, but a smart one, right?
Don't forget the trickster, the colonel.
Wait a minute, Gorilla.
Did you ever see them at ringside when they didn't get involved? Give me a break.
They are there strictly as managers.
Oh, sure.
They don't have tights on.
Tell me about it.
I can't believe what a paranoid guy you are.
Yeah, I've been around too long. That's why I'm paranoid.
And with Mr. Fuji.
Nothing Fuji does would surprise me, Jess.
Would you buy a car from Fuji?
Absolutely not. Or anything else, but that matter.
If he can help out in any way, he's gonna.
Ceremonial salt. Ceremonial.
It's nice to still see tradition in this day and age, yeah. Gorilla.
There aren't too many evil spirits he has to chase away from here, Jess.
You're one.
Well, maybe.
You gotta remember, Fuji hasn't wrestled in years.
Neither have you.
That's right.
Neither have I.
You, many years. Us, just years. You, many years. You, decades. In wrestling, there's a lot of forearms, a lot of punching, a lot of kicking, but when it boils down to it, you still gotta go care how big you are. You go to a man's eyes, you're going to stop him.
Do whatever you have to do, Jess, at this particular point in time.
Oh, it's okay as long as you like him, huh,
Gorilla? No, I didn't say that. I think for everybody involved here, you pull out all the stops, Jess.
That's what I said earlier, Gorilla. I said it's not how you play the game, it's whether you win or lose. And you got all over my case about that.
I didn't say that. I only questioned some of the things that you've said over the years.
I think you've been hanging out with McMahon too much lately.
You think so?
Yeah. He's a bad influence on anybody. Quit arguing with me. It's getting too late in the night to argue with you.
Take a walk. Where you go? You can't go. You can't go back in the locker room. You're the commentator.
Hey, I don't care.
The body thrown his headset down here on the table. Just walked out of here. I can't believe it. I thought he was kidding. He's not turning around. He's three quarters of the way back to the locker room area. And I can't believe it. Jesse just walked out of here. Maybe he'll be back. Only time will tell. Never know what the body's going to do. Both men here wanting to win in the worst way. These guys can both do it all as far as knowing the moves and counter moves in professional wrestling. Once in a while I take a look back towards the dressing room area. I don't see Jesse on his way back.
Storm out of here like that. I'm a professional monsoon.
Sure,
they're paying me big money to be here. I'll learn it, and don't you give me no hard time. I've had enough for now.
Well, perhaps the body's going to stay with us. Perhaps he's not.
Wow. Vicious maneuver, Gorilla Monsoon.
That'll take all the starch out of you, and in a hurry. Given the opportunity, should he slap it on you and complete the maneuver, forget about it. I never saw you do anything like that, Jess.
I was more of a power wrestler.
Yes,
hey, I never saw you do none of that either.
Not at 400.
But then again, at your age, Gorilla, I never saw you at all anyway.
Boy, he is extremely confident, Jess. He thinks he's got it all together. He thinks he has the ability.
Well, I won't argue with you on that, Gino Monsoon. He is something to see. Like I said, he's not just another pretty face.
But we're looking at a guy who's got determination, Jess. We're looking at a guy who's got that, what we talked about earlier on, intestinal fortitude. And in my opinion, got the conditioning that's needed. Plus his forte. He slaps that on you, nails you away, forget about it.
That's right. I love it when he gets a chance to use that.
But it certainly did the job.
Definitely did.
Right on the back of the head, right in the external occipital protuberance area. That'll knock you out to the middle of next week.
A what? Can you repeat that again, Gorilla?
What is that?
What you said there, where he got hit.
That little bump on the back of your head.
Ah, okay. Back of the head for all you normal people out there. Got to do this on his own.
I've always known you over the years in your career, Jess, as always being controversial, and you certainly created more controversy when you reached down and grabbed the bar when it had 712 pounds.
Well, what happened there? Let me explain that quick, Gorilla. I only put 2 pounds of finger pressure on that, so he still did 710.
How can you possibly know how many pounds of pressure, Jess?
When you've been living as long as I have, Gorilla, you know exactly how much. I just put my two little pinkies.
Give me a break.
2 pounds, so he still did 710. There's nothing illegal about that.
I didn't say that.
I didn't say you did. I'm just explaining to the people, Gorilla.
Oh, excuse me.
You know, the one thing that's an advantage for a champion is this. You gotta beat the champ.
That's true.
You know, you gotta pin the champ or make him submit. That's the only way you can get a title.
Oh, I said, Jess, over the years, that once you're the champion, you know, it's not free. Hold on, because...